All right. Now, with the cops here, let's say that I have to... Oh, whoa. Okay. Now, I'm explaining how to guide each thought into the present moment. And I had an example in my mind. Remember, this is just an example of the picture that was in my mind. I was with a woman, and that led to the cops showing up because of the woman's past and her personality in the present moments. She can be a magnet to cops, according to her thoughts. And so, in my mind, I imagine the predicament of being with a woman. And, okay, now I'm at a pause right now because I just moved to a different thought. It was a much more private, personal thought. It's capturing my attention right now. It's a test. But it's also an invitation to share. This would give context as to why I'm including a woman in the story. Okay, now as I'm having thought, I can mold my thoughts any direction. And this is part of why I'm doing this video. And so as I watch my thoughts, just observing them, pass by like clouds, I don't have to agree with them. All that's needed is just to acknowledge their presence. That's all they really want in this life, is just to be acknowledged. And as we're acknowledging these thoughts, giving them no classification, no subject matter, no sense of joining with them, then now this gives me, as the co-creator, the power to add my take. Put my spin on that thought. Put my direction. Put my safety around it. My prayer of safety that this situation is going to turn out for good. And it's going to turn corners according to my pain threshold. If I can't bear the idea of the thought going down this street any further, then I will immediately have a new side road paved right in that I can turn off. Turn onto another street. And that would be the street of pain relief. Until such a time as later that I have gone through that particular, down that particular road many times, and I'm ready to move further on that road. In the meantime, I will take the quickest exits off that freeway because of my own faith, fear levels, balance. My faith and fear balance. So, basically all why I wanted to do this video. Wanted to get that on the record. Yeah, okay, now getting back to the example of the woman. Now, in this, the thoughts that were going through my mind that I was just watching as a movie, the scene played out. She attracted cops to the door, and we were hiding from them in a box. Under a box in the house, in the room, somewhat kind of, you know, less conspicuous. And so in this movie, I saw the cops come in, they're searching around, and we were both under the box, me and the woman. And I started thinking to myself, okay, well, this is just like thoughts. I'm just observing the thoughts, and now I'm going to take this thought in my own direction. And I said to myself, okay, I interject and put my own thoughts in there that said this: the cops won't find us. Or they know that we're under here, but they're just here under orders as a test, because there are MK mind control ultra monitoring the whole situation, as we are all part of the Matrix. And we are learning to detach out of it. Unto higher levels. Higher levels of awareness. Of course, the Matrix is just our own projection also. So if we want, we can change our reality to one of, there is no Matrix. I am in the midst of the natural process of nature and the universe. That what I give my attention to is what I will manifest. If I keep giving my attention to that there's a matrix controlling everything, and that there are elite that run everything, if I give my attention to those things, then that's what I'm going to manifest. But if I purposely interject a new idea, one of my own creation, and say to myself, oh, everything that's happening is a result of the universe's will, of all the angels, of all consciousness put together, they're the ones controlling everything. We are the ones controlling everything. Don't have to deny that the Matrix is there, because that would be just like trying to deny that thoughts that are there. And we all know that we cannot control thoughts coming in.